do realize there's a difference between loving America and being swept up in our 9/11 paranoia.
Brian, are you suggesting that 9/11 didn't change everything?
What?
No, just because 9/11 changed everything, Brian. 9/11 changed everything.
Peter, you didn't even know what 9/11 was until 2004.
That's not true, Brian. I remember 9/11. Cooking bats. A worker and a woman pilot
quickly immersing the corn.
He activates the steam injection heating system. Phone sex line, and as the temperature rises, he tosses in numerous scoops of powdered limestone.
It acts as a preservative and helps soften the kernels during cooking.
Glasses?
As they soften, the outer skin or pericarp loosens, releasing starch and creating
big
a foamy
underwear,
effect.
I guess?
After 45
I'm
minutes,
sorry, what?
They turn off the heat and the corn steams for 8 hours.
Well,
with the kernels softened even more by the long soak, it's time to wash off a lot of the loosened pericarp.
We could watch House.
A little paranoid.
All right, I am totally flaccid, but thank you anyway, ma'am. I appreciate your time.
It will act as a
henceforth, sexual intercourse is illegal. It is gross and disgusting and punishable by death.
Origami keeps my hands busy and my mind off stuff. There we go. Stu's a good leader. I wonder how many of these swans I could fit in my bum.
I'd have to give it to Janet Reed. I've always had this business plan for home delivery or prescription medications, or all that seems like a corner market.
That's stupid. I want to talk about vaginas!
Okay. Peter,
what
if you give me on ice?
He transfers the corn dough to a machine called a pre-sheater. Here, automated cameras push the masses between two sets of rolls.
I'm gonna go put on my Donald Duck costume.
The sheet of dough travels through another machine called the sheet of dough.
The subway vigilante from the 80s?
They roll
I
know
a bit about it back when I was
a stoner on the sheet.
What else is in the news? Oh, Bernie Getz. Did you hear about this? The guy Bernie Getz shot a bunch of buggers on the subway. Don't mind having him with me next time I go see my mother-in-law.
Once inside, the tortilla.
No, but really, New York City is a great place to live. They're a cockroach.
The lowest here has the lowest temperature.
What are your intentions?
This thing is making really cool, and I want to.
You know, Michael, my daughter's womb is not a wildfire for you to doubt with your adolescent seed.
Neither is her lower back or her head.
I understand.
Do you, Michael?
After carefully selecting the hide to be used for the specific whip,
let me ask you a question.
By trimming away the
you ever sit on your arm till the car is asleep and play with yourself and pretend like somebody else is doing it?
Yes.
They now begin cutting out all the loose leather from the clips, most of which are stretched, which shall later braid. The internal construction of the whip is made of two layers of braiding called placket billets. Separating each braided layer is a solid piece of leather called a bolster.
I come in anyway?
It encircles the braided belly layer under it.
I come in
then,
anyway.
Covering everything is a final outer layer of braiding called the overlay.
Okay, I clean?
No, get out of here!
I clean now?
No!
By hand,
I stay and watch?
No!
That's
I get involved?
What?
I get involved with lady?
What do you
the
think?
Finished overlay and bellies have a flat portion at the top called the yolk.
Okay, you lend me money?
No.
You drive my grandmother to a doctor's appointment?
No, I'm not
they
doing that.
Each strand
I stick finger
as much
in your mouth?
Possible to ensure the braid is tight and uniform.
Housekeeping?
Then they resize each strand and bevel the edges. This helps the strand fit into each other.
Check it out, you guys. I got a new cell phone that takes pictures.
Braid.
Look, I took a picture of Lois's
tool called a hand scare.
You
should have
handed out
shikaj
after that one.
That's hilarious.
Hey, did you guys see the game
they take
last
waxed corn and tightly bind a tapered strip of leather around the foundation.
Yeah,
the leather strip
that is even more beautiful shite than 7 degrees
of displacement of heavenly issue shadow before. Then bring the strands to the
we're playing Magic the Gathering. Want to join?
Osama!
Over the braided first belly, drop the first bolster, and attach and braid the second belly.
Okay, there's some problems. So let's take a look.
The second bolster. Each layer compressing the ones underneath.
That old man.
First, they feed the strands with homemade animal fat-based soap.
Go get her!
This not only enables a tighter braid, the animal fat also conditions the leather. This particular
well,
has a 12-strand overlay.
At you earlier. You were right to criticize Beck. She does not even handle this simple task. She's in there right now, taking a nap under one. Good morning, my American family.
Now, where did you get that silk?
You look like the Statue of Liberty's
part of the whip. The fall.
Look, I'm fat and I'm stupid, and I fart at times that ruin my father and my social occasions, and that's why I'm never invited to them.
You pay me now?
And trim the loose strands. This creates a secure connection between
just like
these two
the telephone
sections of
the whip. Killed the telegraph sex business.
Now they roll the thong between
hey baby,
a hard surface
I bet
and
you're
a block
hot.
Of marble.
Stop.
This
describe to me what you're doing to yourself
rounds out
right
the overall
now.
Shape.
Stop.
Then they tie the cracker onto the
bottom. Oh, nasty!
In the old days, they used horsehair for the cracker. Also known as bumper. Nowadays, nicknames are more likely to use nylon silk. They wrap it up in leather to build a knot foundation at the base of the handle. For longer and thicker whips, they use a knot foundation to make it lead to properly balance. They fold the yoke from the leather over the foundation. Then, with a separate strand of leather, cover the foundation with what's known as a Turk's head knot. Lastly, they apply a coat of natural shellac to the entire whip. This protects the materials and produces a nice sheen.